Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you could transfer photos and videos from your iPhone to your Windows 10 PC. It's actually pretty easy to do, and I'm going to walk you through how to do that today. All right, well, let's jump into it. So I have a whole bunch of photos on my phone. I went to the Museum of Flight yesterday with my son yesterday, and I want to take these photos from my phone and put them on my computer. So how do I go about doing that? Well, I'm going to show you three different techniques to do it. The first one uses the Photos app that comes with Windows 10. The second technique uses File Explorer. And then the third technique is something that you could just do in the cloud, which is using the Google Photos app. All right, well, let's run through the three different techniques. So the first technique using the Windows Photo app. So what I need to do first is I have my iPhone here and I need to plug it into my computer. So I have this Lightning cable. It's already plugged into my computer and my USB port. And so I'm going to go ahead and plug it into my computer. And now I get a message on my computer screen here that says Apple iPhone, select to choose what happens with this device. And so on the screen, you'll see that I have a few different options. I have one that says import photos and videos. And then I have other ones, you know, open device to view files. And what I want to do is first we're going to look at the photos and videos app. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this using the Photos app. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And so what's happening now is the app is looking for all the photos on the device. Now, the nice thing is the Photos app comes in box as part of Windows 10. That means if you have Windows 10 on your computer, you also have access to the Photos app. And so here it looks like it found a whole bunch of photos. So I'm going to unselect all. And what we're going to do is I'm just going to import a few of these. So let's just import all the photos from my trip yesterday to the Museum of Flight. So I'm going to bring them all in. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna click on import selected. Okay, so now it's importing all the images and it looks like it brought them in automatically. So here we are with the 787 in the background. Here's a picture of me and my son in front of one of the original Boeing 747s. And then here we are in the loading bay of the space shuttle. So kind of a few kind of fun photos. And what I could do then is I could edit these photos. Let's say I wanna crop, add filter, effects. Let's say ahead and share the photos. So there's a lot that I could do with it. You could bring in photos, you could bring in videos, any of that works using the Photos app. So that's probably the easiest way to import photos to your computer. Now I want to show another technique too. So I'm going to close out the Photos app. And this is something that'll work if you're also on an older version of Windows. So maybe you don't have the Photos app. So I'm going to actually just unplug the phone and then we're going to plug that back in here. So once again, I get this dialogue, and instead of clicking on the import photos and videos using the Photo app, what I want to do is I want to open the device to view files using File Explorer. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And so what you'll see now is it's on the it's selected on the iPhone. Here, if I look on the left-hand side, I see that device is selected, and I'll go ahead and click on the internal storage. There's this folder called DCIM. That's where the iPhone stores all the photos. Another folder, click into that one. And then once I click in, I see all my photos and all my videos on the device. So what I could do is I'm going to go ahead and just make this window a little bit smaller. And so I could actually go through and I could just select files and then I can right click to copy. And then let's say I just want to put on my desktop, I could right click and I could paste. And here all the photos are also on my PC now as well. So there was a picture of my son and here's a picture of him again at the Museum of Flight. So very simple to copy and then paste photos on your computer using File Explorer. The Photos app is probably the easiest. File Explorer is a little more detailed because you have to choose where you want to place the photo. So the third technique that I want to talk through is using Google Photos to get photos onto your computer. So how do you do that? Well, the first thing is you need to go to the App Store and you need to install the Google Photos app. So simply click on App Store and then search for Google Photos. Once you have Google Photos installed, you'll see an app icon on your phone that's called Google Photos. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And what'll happen now is once the app opens, it'll identify all the photos that are on my phone. So here it's looking at all the photos and you see that it's synchronizing or backing up with Google Photos. So it's going through and it's backing up the 20 photos. And while that's happening, what I could do now is on my desktop, I'm gonna open up my browser and I'm gonna navigate to photos.google.com. And now I'm gonna just refresh this page and you'll see that all these photos from the Museum of Flight are now showing up on my photos.google.com. And so what I could do is I could either view them right here on my computer, or what I could do is I could hit that checkbox and I could even select multiple images. And if I click on this dot, dot, dot in the top right hand corner, I could then click on download. So I'm gonna go ahead and download these. And what that did now is it downloaded a zip file with all my photos. Now, the nice thing about using Google Photos is not only do you get a backup on Google or in the cloud, but you don't have to hook up a cord with your computer. As long as you have Wi-Fi, or if you just have cellular data, you could load up the Google Photos app. It'll upload it to Google Photos, and then you could get it on your PC, and you could download it to your computer, or you could just leave it in the cloud. The Google Photos technique, that's my favorite, just because you get that backup and it's pretty easy. You don't have to kind of get this clunky cord and hook it up to your computer. So all in all, pretty easy. Those are three different techniques how you could take photos that are on your iPhone and then you could transfer them to your computer, whether it's a photo, whether it's a video. So all in all, it's pretty easy. Hopefully this quick tutorial was helpful and you learned how to transfer photos and videos from your phone to your computer. If it was, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see future videos like this, please hit that subscribe button. That way you'll be notified anytime new content like this comes out. And lastly, if there's anything else that you're trying to learn about, anything else that you want me to create a video on, leave a comment down below. I read them all. And if there are any video ideas, I'll add it to my list for future videos. All right. Well, thanks a lot. That's all I had for you today. I'll see you next time. Bye.